Shimla, Kulu and Manali are the three most popular tourist destinations of Indian state Himachal Pradesh. Among these three, Shimla is the largest city of this state and also serves as the state capital. Surrounded by snow-capped Himalayan mountains and dense green forest, the city is one of the most loved hill stations of the nation. During the British period, Shimla served as the summer capital of the British rulers. Other than some beautiful tourist attractions, the city now has the UNESCO World Heritage Mountain Railways of India, the Kalka-Shimla Railway. Kulu is a beautiful pine-clad valley located in Himachal Pradesh, which is famous for its panoramic view of the Himalayan mountain range. It is the capital town of the Kulu district of Himachal Pradesh. Manali is another beautiful town of the Kulu district of Himachal Pradesh. Here is a tour guide of these three beautiful locations of Himachal Pradesh. Start your tour from Shimla. The best time to visit Shimla is from November to June. How to reach? Shimla can be reached both by train or air. The nearest railway station of Shimla is Kalka, which is around 85 km away from the town. From Kalka, you can go to Shimla either by car or can avail the famous Kalka-Shimla narrow gauge toy train. The Kalka-Shimla toy train route passes mostly through the mountains and is well known for the scenic views of the surrounding mountains and valleys. This route passes through a total of 102 tunnels and it takes almost 5 hours to reach Shimla from Kalka. The nearest major airport of Shimla is Chandigarh. The distance of Shimla from Chandigarh is around 114 km and it will take almost 4 hours to reach Shimla from Chandigarh by road. Day 1. On day 1 of your tour, first go to visit Tara Devi Temple. This is a 250 years old temple. The main deity here is Tibetan Buddhist goddess Tara. The temple is located on the Tara Parvat and you will get a beautiful view of the surrounding mountains and valleys from the courtyard of this temple. Next, go to visit Sankat Mochan Temple. It is approximately 5 km away from Shimla city centre. This tranquil temple is surrounded by a forest of beautiful pine and oak trees. This temple houses three deities, Lord Rama, Lord Shiva and Lord Hanuman. Nowadays, it is one of the most famous tourist attractions near Shimla. From Sankat Mochan Temple, go to visit Shimla Kalibadi. It is a popular tourist attraction in the city. This beautiful temple was constructed in the year 1845 and the main deity here is Goddess Kali. From Kalibari Temple, go to visit famous Shimla Mall. Shimla Mall Road is the main street in Shimla and is the most happening place in the town. You will find all the government offices, post office, banks, everything here. Other than the offices, there are numerous big and small stores located here. There are also some roadside wool shops. If you love knitting, you may buy wools from here at a very reasonable price. The upper level of Mall Road is known as the Ridge, which is a big open area. We went there at the time of sunset and observed a spectacular sunset from there. after sundown, we came down to the Mall Road and went to a famous cafe at Shimla Mall Road. Your Shimla tour will be incomplete unless you taste the delicious cookies, cakes or hot chocolates from here. We had cheesecakes and hot chocolates, which taste heavenly. Day 2. On day 2 morning, we had our breakfast in a roadside eatery. The stall sells momo and Maggi noodles cooked with lots of veggies. We had Maggi and that was delicious. After breakfast, start your journey towards Jakku Temple. The temple is located on top of Jakku Hill. It is an ancient temple dedicated to Lord Hanuman. According to Ramayana, Lord Hanuman rested here for some time while he was searching for Sanjeevani Booty to revive Lakshman. Every year, a festival is held here during Dasera. A giant 108 feet tall statue of Lord Hanuman was established here in the year 2010. You can reach the hilltop by taxi, horse or ropeway. From Jakku Hill, move towards Kufri. On your way, first stop at Green Valley. Green Valley is a stunning mountain valley famous for its breathtaking views of the surrounding pine and deodar forest over vast hilly lands. After spending some time at Green Valley, start your journey towards Kufri. Enjoy the scenic beauty of the pine-clad valleys on your way. Due to this overwhelming beauty, the road to Kufri needs a special mention here. The car parking space of Kufri is a little ahead of the viewpoints and fun world. At the car parking space, you can enjoy a photo shoot sitting on the back of a yak. From the car parking space to the sightseeing point, horse ride is available. Charges are Rs. 500 per person. You have to pay a road tax of Rs. 20 here. At the entrance of Kufri viewpoints, there is a small market having stalls of local handmade products and local fast food. Beyond this zone, you will find the telescope point. From here, you can get a closer look at the Himalayan mountain ranges using the telescope. There is a guide who will explain every detail to you.
Indira Gandhi, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto ki Kashmir mudde par first baithak hua tha yahan par. Iska do teen jagah baithak hua. Shooting spot yahan par Hindi film mein banti hai. सबसे पहले बनी मर्द
फिल्म। Other than viewing telescope, you can take photos sitting on a yak's back. If you are an adventure sports lover, then you can enjoy archery at this point. Beyond this, there is a local village. Enjoy a walk around this village and have a glimpse of the local life here. Next, go to visit Kufri Fun World. Kufri Fun World is an amusement park where you will have numerous fun and adventure activities for both kids and adults. Other than these activities, there are some good eateries inside the Fun World where you can enjoy snacks and a cup of hot tea. The package cost for all the adventure activities in Kufri is between Rs. 200 and 300. After completing your activities in the Kufri Fun World, go to visit Himalayan Nature Park or Kufri Zoo. Enjoy quality time here. From the zoo, go to visit the local market at Kufri, Chini Bazar. Here you will find many small wooden handcrafted products which you may collect as a souvenir. After that, return to Shimla town and go to visit the famous Shimla Lakkar Bazar. This market sells mainly wooden handicraft products and is located adjacent to the famous Shimla Ridge. Next, go to the ridge. You can have a lift to go to the ridge from Lakkar Bazar. This is the heart of this beautiful hilly town, and the place offers breathtaking views of surrounding mountains. This place also houses some notable shops and buildings. From Ridge, go to visit the famous Shimla Christ Church. It is the second oldest church in North India and was built in the Neo-Gothic style in the year 1857. In the evening, the church is lightened up and looks like a magnificent castle. In Shimla, you will have a shared or reserved taxi for a sightseeing tour. The carfare for a day-long sightseeing tour will cost around ₹1,500 per day. On day 3 morning, start your journey to Kullu from Shimla. We went to Kullu from Shimla by shared car, which charged ₹1,200 per person. The distance of Kullu from Shimla is around 208 km and it will take almost 5 to 6 hours to reach Kullu from Shimla without any break. On our way to Kullu, we visited some of the tourist attractions of the place. And in our case, it took almost 8 hours to reach Kullu from Shimla. There is also bus service available from Shimla to Kullu. If you wish, you can avail buses to reach Kullu from Shimla. First, we visited Sundarnagar Lake. It is a beautiful man-made lake on the way to Kullu, built using the waters of Bias and Satluj River. Next, visit the Pando Dam. The dam was built in the year 1977 to generate hydroelectric power for the area. From there, go to visit the famous Hanogi Mata Temple of Kullu. Located on a hilltop, this tiny temple is dedicated to Mata Hanogi and is famous for its picturesque backdrop. Next, we visited Jhiri Nature Park. The entry fee to this park is ₹20 per person. It is a place where you can enjoy paragliding and river rafting. Paragliding will cost ₹3,500 per head and river rafting will cost ₹600 per head. If you are an adventure sports lover, then this is a must visit place for you. Day 4. On the fourth day of your tour, go to local sightseeing in Kullu. First, go to visit the Kullu Vaishno Devi Temple. Located on the banks of River Bias, Vaishno Devi Temple of Kullu is a Hindu shrine dedicated to goddess Parvati. The temple is famous for its calm and quiet environment. Next, visit the Kullu shawl industry. Kullu is famous for its colorful woolen shawl. It is worthy to visit one of the shawl industries while you are in Kullu. From there, go to visit Dhakpo Shedrupling Monastery. This is a Buddhist shrine situated on the banks of River Bias. Surrounded by beautiful Himalayan mountains, this monastery lies on top of the list of most visited places in Kullu. The monastery complex is very neat and clean. There is also an open-air cafe inside the monastery. Sitting here, you can enjoy the freshness of nature. From there, go to visit Basheshwar Mahadev Temple. This majestic temple was built during the 9th century AD and was made in a pyramid style. It is located on the banks of River Bias, and Lord Shiva and his wife Goddess Parvati are the main deities here. Currently, the temple is popular for its serene environment. Next, visit Raghunath Temple. Located at a height of 2056 meters above the sea level, this beautiful temple is dedicated to Lord Rama. From there, go to visit Jagannathi Mata Temple. Built approximately 1500 years ago, this temple is dedicated to Goddess Bhuvaneshwari, the sister of Lord Vishnu. The temple was built in Pahari style. In the afternoon, take a bus or car from Kullu and start your journey towards Manali. We took a bus from Kullu to go to Manali. The bus fare was Rs. 70 per person. Manali is approximately 42 km away from Kullu, and it will take around 2 hours to reach Manali from Kullu. Due to bad weather and time constraint, we were not able to visit the famous hot spring at Manikaran. If you are visiting this place, then please do visit the famous hot spring at Manikaran. It is really beautiful. Day 5. On the 5th morning, go for a sightseeing tour around Manali. Here, local cab fare for a day-long sightseeing tour is around ₹1,500. First, go to visit Gulaba. Gulaba is a picturesque village around Manali and on the way to Rotang Pass. The village is now a popular tourist attraction of Manali, which is famous for natural beauty. We experience little snowfall here. Horse riding facility is also available at this point. Enjoy a walk around this beautiful snow-covered valley. Next, go to Solang Valley. Solang Valley is a side valley on the way to Rotang Pass from Manali. The place is popular for different adventure sports activities. You can enjoy paragliding, skating, and zorbing here. From Solang Valley, go to visit Kothi. Kothi is a scenic village located at the bottom of Rotang Pass on the Lahol-Spiti-Leh Highway. This is now a popular tourist spot and a must visit for people who love photography. Due to heavy snow, we were unable to visit Rotang Pass. We returned from Kothi and next went to Him Valley Park. This is an amusement park at Manali. The entry fee to the park is ₹200 per person. In this park, you will find many rides and boating. Other than these activities, here you can enjoy the magic show performed by local magicians.
1, 2, 3. Funk lagao. Mitti ko lagao. Tod ke do.
Nice.
Bajra. Do banaye koi kalakari nahi, kalakari ab dekhna. Dekhiye ab sir. Funk lagayenge. Murek. Kaan mein chhod denge. Khali katori hai.
The most attractive part here is the folk dance performance of the local dancers. We enjoyed that show a lot. From Him Valley Park, go to visit the last destination of the day, Nehru Point. It is a beautiful natural spring that originated from Virigu Lake. The spring is famous for its breathtaking surroundings and pure cold water. Day 6. On day 6 morning, first go to Hamta Pass. Hamta Pass is a corridor between Chandra Valley of Lahul and Kullu Valley. We went to the point where the famous Hamta Pass trek begins. This place is covered with high altitude grassland, and as per our expectation, the beauty of this place is surreal. We faced little snowfall here. We waited at a tea stall till the snowfall subsided, and then we walked around the snow-covered mountain slopes for a while. From Hamta Pass, go to Panduropa. It is a small grassland at the bottom of the hill. There is a small stream that passes through this grassland. The place is surrounded by pine-covered mountains. It is a beautiful campsite where you may stay for the night. From Panduropa, go to Vasishth Bath. It is a natural hot spring. The water of this hot spring is believed to have medicinal values. There is a temple beside this hot spring. The surrounding of the place needs a special mention. Next, visit Manu Temple. This famous temple is dedicated to sage Manu. The temple is located on Bias River Valley near Manali. The place is well known for scenic beauty. You can spend some quality time observing the beautiful surroundings of this place. From Manu Temple, go to the most popular tourist destination of Manali, Hinma Devi Temple. At the entrance of this temple, you will find some local handmade woolen garments shop. This temple is located inside the beautiful cedar forest locally known as Dhungri Van Vihar. This unique temple is dedicated to Hidimba Devi, wife of second Pandav Bhim, who was a famous figure of epic Mahabharata. Besides this temple, there is another temple dedicated to goddess Hidimba's son Ghatotkach. At the end of this temple complex, you can enjoy yak ride or can even take a picture sitting on a yak's back. Next, go to visit Manali Van Vihar. Van Vihar is a nature park located in Manali. The park is surrounded by long deodar trees. Enjoy a walk around the calm and quiet paths of this park. If you wish, you can do boating here. The entry fee to this park is Rs. 50 per person. Next, go to Manali Monastery. This monastery is located near Manali Mall and is famous for its serene environment. In the evening, walk around the famous Manali Mall and enjoy some shopping. Day 7. On day 7 morning, we visited Manali Mall and purchased some woolen garments from there. After that, we took a bus from Manali and started our journey towards Chandigarh for departure. The Volvo fare from Manali to Chandigarh is ₹1,150 and the non-Volvo bus fare is ₹540. It will take almost 10 hours to reach Chandigarh from Manali. Where to stay? At Shimla, we stayed at Hotel Angan Regency, which is located near Mall Road. The room tariff was around ₹1,700 per day. At Manali, we stayed at Hotel Thakur, where the room charge was around ₹900. Both of these are OYO hotels. We will share the online booking links in the description box below. To know the total package cost, please check the description box. If you love this tour plan, then please like and share the video. Also, do let us know your opinion in the comment section below. Your opinion means a lot to us. Thanks for watching it.